While fossil evidence suggests we could be somewhat older than at first suspected, the generally accepted theory for evolution says that we began in Ethiopia roughly 200,000 years ago. From then, we evolved into what we are now, but the modern day humans of the early 21st century look very different to our early ancestors. But of course, without Instagram or even a humble oil painting, how do we even really know how different we looked? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, a channel now sitting pretty with over a million subscribers. Hip hip hooray. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what did humans really look like 200,000 years ago? Before we get into this video, I want to ask you guys to let me know what you look like using emojis in the comments section down below. You can't see my face, but it's somewhere between the ginger and black haired emoji, the frog face, and the lipstick pic. Nah. Also, while you're down there, why don't you guys leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend. Thanks! These days humans come with lots of variants. Light skin, dark skin, lightish skin, darkish skin, blonde, ginger, brunette, black haired, green eyes, blue eyes, brown, in some rare cases violet eyes, curly hair, straight hair, all the hairs. That was not always the case. 200,000 years ago, as humans were beginning to take form, there were three species of us: Homo sapiens, our modern ancestors, Homo erectus, and Neanderthals. While we bred amongst one another, the three species did look somewhat different. Thanks to found fossils and scientific knowledge as well as modern reconstruction technology, we have a rough idea of what our early ancestors looked like. Homo erectus, who were still around 200,000 years ago, looked least like we do today. They looked far more ape-like and were, by all intent and purpose, far more primitive and animalistic. The Homo erectus had large bodies and bigger brains than us, around 60% the volume that we do today, but of course it isn't size that matters, it's how we use it. The Homo erectus could be taller too, reaching nearing 6 foot, although the variants in the species were wider too. They had a lot of shorties as well. They had strong, dexterous hands, coarse hair, and very big noses, plus ape-like brow ridges. The Homo erectus were very, very, very dark-skinned, and they became extinct 70,000 years ago. Neanderthals had much lighter skin and were hairy. They had bigger-looking faces with wider facial features than humans today. Their noses were broad and projecting. Their chins were small. It is thought they had a prominent brow ridge. Their skulls were elongated. They had big jaws and space behind their wisdom teeth. It is thought that Neanderthals had straight and thick hair. It's also thought that their faces were rosy, their eyes were big, and their hands were wide. Neanderthals are thought to have been the origin bearers of red hair, having the same distribution of hair color as modern Eurasians. It is thought that Neanderthals were shorter than Homo sapiens, averaging 1.6 meters. Neanderthals were Homo sapiens' main competition, but they too died out 28,000 years ago. While Homo sapiens did mix with the other two early ancestors, they can be defined as being dark-skinned, leaner and more muscular and much taller than us. The early Homo sapiens were the bringers of the more rounded skull. Our jaws were pretty wide and our noses were bigger, but nowhere near as big as Neanderthals and the Homo erectus. We know that Homo sapiens were the beginnings of intelligence, which is what helped our early ancestors survive and outlive the competition. With that intelligence, I imagine our early ancestors had a look of understanding in their eyes that Homo erectus and Neanderthals didn't quite. As time went on, humans got smaller. 9,000 years ago, we ditched our hunter-gatherer lifestyles and started agricultural farming, which shifted the ways that our body looks. Around 7,000 years ago were the first truly lighter-skinned humans. They began emerging. One of the biggest visual differences between us and our ancestors 200,000 years ago would be hair and dress. Back then, humans didn't worry about hairstyles, makeup, and flattering outfits. Hair was fully grown out on both males and females, and everything they wore was fit for purpose. Animal skins would have been worn to protect areas that needed protecting, and we probably would have looked pretty dirty, seeing as we spent much of our time outdoors or in rudimentary shelters. There weren't dentists or doctors to fix teeth and broken bones back then, so likely we would have looked pretty rugged. Humans would have looked more homogenized too. There wouldn't be fat and thin humans, just alive and functional. Genetically, we would be a lot closer to one another back then. Evolution has allowed for variation to flourish, although that being said, the establishment of countries and borders later re-encouraged less selective gene pools, but that's a whole different discussion. So guys, there we have it. That is what we know so far. Perhaps as reconstruction and technology develops and our understanding and interpretation of fossils grows, we may have a better idea of what we looked like back then. Until then though, this is what we have to go on. What do you guys think of our early ancestors? Do you think they look more intriguing than we do? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. below. Also, while you're down there, why don't you like this video and share it with a history-loving friend. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.